हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर डूइंग ग्रेट। आई एम लक्ष्मी। वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैथ्स सुपर टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स। इन दिस चैनल आई एम गोइंग टू टीच द वेरियस लेवल्स ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्टिव टाइप एग्जामिनेशंस, एस्पेशली जेईई मेंस एंड एमसेट, विद अमेजिंग सुपर टिप्स एंड ट्रिक्स आई एम यूजिंग रिगार्डिंग द मैथ्स। यू नो मैथ्स हैज अ प्लेंटी ऑफ द टॉपिक्स एंड इट इज वन ऑफ द मेजर सब्जेक्ट, सो यू कैन कम अक्रॉस ईजिली विदाउट वेस्टिंग योर टाइम। Just you can watch my videos because I'm using the very very simple and shortcut methods, as well as in each and every video I'm explaining the every topic with concept and also including the previous MCET and JEE mains questions. Those are also very very helpful to you. Okay, if you're not yet subscribed my channel, please subscribe. At the same time click the bell notification, then every video notification is to you without missing. You can watch it. Those are very very helpful to you for your better progress. Okay, in today's session I'm going to start one of the quite interesting and very very important topic as a part 2. Already I explained the uploaded the part 1, whose link is there in the description, and also I added the playlist in the description. You can check the playlist also, right? And some videos can be opened by click the I button on top corner of every video. So those are also very very helpful to you. So if you have any doubts regarding this one, please put a comment. Definitely I will rectify your doubts. In this today's session I'm discussing about the functions as a part 2, especially how can you find out the inverse of some standard functions. How can you find out the inverse of standard functions? I'm using the super tips and tricks. Within 2 seconds you can get the solution. And also some questions I will use of what is the simple process of finding inverse of a given function. Are you ready? Yes. Look at the question number 1. What is there here? In question number 1, given that the function f from this is domain 0 infinity is open interval to minus infinity to plus infinity is also open interval. This is domain, this is codomain. Is given function is defined as f of x is equal to log x to the base 3. Then is asking the f inverse x. To find out its inverse, simply just only 1 second, f inverse x, we can take 3 power x. F inverse x is in the form of 3 power x when f of x is in the form of log x to the base e, base 3. How it is? Look at this tip. Super tip we can use. Suppose f of x is in the form of log x to the base e, then its inverse, f inverse x, we can take simply a power x. What is f inverse x is? A power x. Same way, in place of a, whatever may be letter is there, nothing to worry about that one. In place of a, the 3 is there. Therefore, what is that? A power x means what? 3 power x. That's it. It is clearly first option, right? It is takes only 1 or 2 seconds. If you know this super tip. Okay, now come to the next question. If f from R to R defined by f of x is equals to x plus 1 by 3, then f inverse x, we can find out this inverse. Just simply f inverse x I'm writing as 3x minus 1 by 2. 3x minus 1 by 2, that is f inverse x. 3x minus 1 by 2 we can write by using this super tip. That is what? If the f of x is in the form of some ax plus b by c, f of x is in the form of ax plus b by c, then its inverse we can write cx minus b by a. We can understand easily how we can remember it. For example, in this given f of x is multiplied with a, that will be divided. C is divisible, that should be multiplied with x, and also b is added, the addition of b here subtracting. Like that you can remember this tip easily, right? If f of x is in the form of ax plus b by c, then f inverse x is what? Cx minus b by a. According to the given question, in place of a, 2 is there, that is 2 here, and c 3, 3x plus 1 becomes minus 1. Is it clear? That is clearly first option, that's it. Now I can come to the next questions. Now what about question number 3? If f of x is given is in the form of 3x minus 1, then f inverse x, simply I'm taking the f inverse x as x plus 1 by 3. Just now only I have given hint in that case. Question number 4, same way here also we can remember it. Here we can remember here x is multiplied with 3 and minus 1 is added. Addition becomes plus, minus 1 is added means or subtracting. 1 is subtracted is becomes addition and multiplying 3 is divisible by 3. So this is, for this also you can remember this step. So what is this, this step? If f of x is in the form of ax plus b, then its inverse, f inverse x we can write bx minus b, x minus b by a, x minus b by a, ax plus b we can add x minus b by a, plus b becomes minus b, multiple of a is divisible by a. Okay, this function we can remember like this. Same here, what is in place of the a, 3 is there, that is should be divided, b minus 1 becomes plus 1 for x, that's it. X plus 1 by 3 is which option? Clearly third option. Now we can come to the next question. Number 4. What is given here? If r plus 2r, this is given domain is r plus because the logarithm is defined only for positive real numbers. And the domain, codomain is r here. Okay, nothing to worry about this one. Some cases you have to concentrate on domain and codomain also. Here, yeah, no need to worry about the, here. No about the domain and codomain in this case. If f from so and so such that f of x is given as what, log x to the base 5, then is asking f inverse x. So can you guess what is this? Already I did the question number 1, same model. F of x is in the form of what? Log x to the base 5. Now f inverse x is clearly a power x. What is the tip I have given? Yes, log x to the base a f of x. This tip you can remember is what? F of x is log x to the base a is there, then its inverse is what? A power x, that's it. That is all we are using here. In place of a, there is 5. 5 power x means what? Clearly, fourth option, right? Now, observe the question number 5. If f from r to 0 to infinity is defined as f of x is 20, 21 power x, then its inverse is asking. We can find out inverse of this is, just I am writing f inverse x is here, log x to the base 20, 21. So, log x to the base 20, 21 f inverse x means inverse of this function you can pick up immediately, log x to the base 20, 21. Which option? It is clearly second option. How we can get? Just you can concentrate this step. If the f of x in the form of a power x, if f of x in the form of a power x, then its inverse is, f inverse x is log x to the base a. You know, this is called as exponential function, this is a logarithmic function. Exponential and logarithmic functions are reciprocal inverse to each other. Means inverse of this is this thing, inverse of the this is this thing. So, in previous questions, I used the log x to the base a is inverse is a power x. Now, we can think in reverse. A power x inverse is log x to the base a. That is only used here. Log x to the base a. In place of a, what is that? 20, 21. In place of 20, 21, any value will go. Right? Clear? Now, can come to the next question number 6. What is given here? A function f from r to r is defined as f of x is 10x minus 7 and g is given as f inverse x. This question is given in MCET 2005. So, f of x is given as 10x minus 7. And also gf are equal, g and f inverse are equal is given. Then he is asking the g inverse, g, he is asking g of x. G of x means indirectly he is asking what, f inverse x or not? Because of g is equal to f inverse x, right? So, indirectly what is f of x inverse? What is inverse of f of x here? It is in the form of ax plus b, right? F inverse x is clearly what? X plus 7 by 10. You have to remember this is in the form of what? Ax plus b or not? This is ax plus b form. That means x minus b by a, x minus b minus or minus plus 7 by a is a 10. This is f inverse x. F inverse x is not asking directly. F inverse x is g means it is asking the indirectly f inverse x only. That means g of x. Okay, right. So what is the option? X plus 7 by 10 is the second option. Don't think inverse is reciprocal. Reverse, it's not reverse. Don't pick up this option. This is a wrong option. Inverse is not a reciprocal of the function, right? So I will explain how we can get this also. In next courses, you can get the idea. Okay, right. Come to the question number 7. Is given that f of x is a 2 plus x cube, then it's asking f inverse x. To find out this one, just simple process is there. I am doing that is, actually from that simple process only, we can get the previous steps. Okay, here f of x is 2 plus x cube is given. This function is taken as some y. Let y is equals to 2 plus x cube. To find out the inverse of so and so function, we can take that function is some y. After that, whatever may be x, we can write in terms of y. Here x, y is equals 2 plus x cube. We want x in terms of y, means we can take 2 is the left side. That means it becomes y minus 2 is equals to x cube. Right. We want only x. Indirectly, x cube is a y minus 2, means x is a cube root of y minus 2 or not? X is a cube root of y minus 2. After x is in terms of entirely in y, then wherever maybe y is there, you can replace x. That is on a required inverse. Means what? What is our required inverse? F inverse x in this case. In place of y, simply have to replace x. Therefore, this is cube root of what? X minus 2. That is on our inverse. This is simple process. Okay. First, what I have to take? To find out inverse of any function, you can take the y of y is that function. And from that function, you can write x in terms of entirely in y, and in place of y, replace x. That is all a required inverse, right? So this is which option? F inverse x is equals cube root of x minus 2. That is clearly fourth option, right? Now come to the next question. What is given here? F of x is given as 2x minus 3. G of x is given as x plus 5. Then is asking the F inverse circle G inverse of 4. Here fx and g of x are in the form of ax plus b or not? We have to find out, f inverse of f inverse circle g inverse of 4. First we have to find out f inverse x and g inverse x. So how can you find out f inverse x and g inverse x? You know what this is? F of x is in the form of what? Ax plus b. What is the tip? Already I have given to you. You can recollect it. F inverse x is what? X minus b by a. X minus b by a. X minus b means what? Plus 3. Minus or minus? Plus 3. By a is a 2. This is f inverse x. Now you can concentrate on g inverse x. G inverse x also same formula, but in place of a, 1 is there. That's why here simply x minus b only will come. It means in place of b, what is there? 5 is there. X minus 5. This is f inverse x. This is g inverse x. What we want? We want f inverse circle g inverse of 4. Therefore, f inverse circle g inverse of 4, how can you find out? Already in part 1, I discussed about the composite functions. This is circle indicates a composite function. How can you find out f circle g, g circle of etc. I did many questions in the previous part. If you not yet watched that part 1, you can watch it, because those are the very, very important questions. And also, in part 1, I discussed about the which contents we can come across the total functions also explained. Right. So f inverse circle g inverse, f inverse circle g inverse of 4. Anybody? Simply f inverse of this circle you can take as a bracket and g inverse x. In place of x, what is there? 4 is there. Right. Now what is meaning of this is f inverse of g inverse 4 means f inverse is as to g inverse 4. How can you find out g inverse 4 for a value? In place of g inverse x function, this is g inverse x function. Here x in place of x, what is there? 4 is there. 4 you have to replace, right? In place of this is in x plus, we can replace the 4. 4 minus 5. That means the resultant is next f inverse minus 1. F inverse minus 1 we got. Means what you have to find out f inverse minus 1 from the f inverse x function. What is f inverse x function is? X plus 3 by 2. But we want in place of x is minus 1. Replace the minus 1 here in a function f inverse. Minus 1 plus 3 by 2. Minus 1 plus 3 is a 2. 2 by 2 is a 1. Right. Which option? So it's clearly first option. That's it. Okay. Now we can come across some more questions. Question number 9. What is given here? If f of x is in the form of x square plus 1 minus 1. F of x in the form of what? X square x plus 1 whole square with minus 1. Then set of values of x we want is equations we want when f of x is equals to f inverse x. What is the meaning of this statement? Set x such that f of x is equals to f inverse x is equals to means we want the set of values of x which are satisfying on this equation. What is this equation? F of x is equals to f inverse x. This is given MCET 2018. Means what? To find out the x values, set of the values of x, to equate the f of x equals to f inverse x, f of x already we have to find out f inverse x. Okay, to find out f inverse x, what I have given is simple process. Yes, we can take the given function f of x as y. Let y is right, x plus 1 whole square minus 1. Then what I said? Totally x in terms of y how to write. Y is equal to x plus 1 whole square minus 1 means what? First minus 1 we can take left side, that means y plus 1 it becomes is equals to x plus 1 whole square, right? After that we take the square here becomes square root, that is root over y plus 1 is equals to x plus 1. Then what you have to do? Yes, this 1 also we can take into left side, that is root over y plus 1 with minus 1. This is clearly x. I said to you after collecting the x in terms of y, what is f inverse x? Simply in place of y you have to write what? X. Therefore, what is f inverse x now? F inverse x is equals to square root of x plus 1 with minus 1, right? We have to equate what? F of x is equal to f inverse x to find out x values. X. F of x means what? X plus 1 whole square with minus 1 is equals to f inverse x is root over x plus 1 with minus 1. You know, plus 1 minus 1 cancel. What is the left over? X plus 1 whole square with is equals root over x plus 1 is left over. Again, squaring on both sides, x plus 1 whole square becomes x plus 1 whole power 4 is equals to right side x plus 1. Right. You know, here x plus 1 whole power 4, here x plus 1. Take the one x plus 1 is our left side, becomes x plus 1 whole power 4 minus x plus 1 equals to 0, right? After that, we can concentrate from these two. Shall I take x plus 1 is common? By taking x plus 1 is common, what is left over here? X plus 1 whole power 3 with the minus 1, right? You know, from this one, x plus 1 is one of the factor, means x is equals to minus 1 is one of the value of x. And one more factor is what? What is one more factor here? What is that one more factor? X plus 1 whole cube. X plus 1 whole cube is equals to 1. Means x plus 1 is equals to cube root of 1 means 1 only. XX cancel. Here x plus 1 is equal to 1 means what? What is cancel? 1 cancel on both sides means x is equals to 0. We got the x values, two values. What are those? X is equals to minus 1 is one of the value and x is equals to 0 is another value. These two values are set of the values of x. Set, you know, is mentioned like this. You know, first option is what? Set 0, 1, minus 1. Is it 0, 1, minus 1? No, it's not correct. It is clearly set 0, minus 1. Only second option, right? Okay, like that some additional work is given here, not asking directly f inverse x. Is given that f inverse x and f are equal, then what is a set of the values of x is asking. That is only difference, right? If you know the concept, you can collect the any type of question. Just the concept is important, right? Now come to the next question, number 10. This is given as, if f from closed interval minus infinity to infinity tends to closed interval 0 to open interval infinity. You know, closed interval, open interval, I think so you know very well. So, try to understand. Closed interval means you can take that value including, open interval means excluding. You know, infinity is always we can keep in open interval only because of infinity cannot take. Okay, that is doesn't matter in this question. Just you have to concentrate on this function. What is given function? F of x is equal to x minus 1 by x. Then what is asking? F inverse x. To find out its inverse, what I given hint? Yes, you can take the process. So y is, you can take as x minus 1 by x, right? Take the LCM here, x square minus 1 by x. By taking the x is LCM here, x index x square minus 1 by x. Next, what you have to do? What I said? We can write x in terms of y. Further, take the cross multiplication. X into y, xy is equals to x square minus 1. Directly like this, in previous question, we can write x in terms of entirely y. Because here x square is there, quadratic expression it becomes. For this, what you have to do? We can write as a quadratic expression form, like equation form. X square asked is, this xy, if you take the right side, becomes minus xy. And minus 1 is as it is equals to 0. Now it is in the form of what? Ax square plus bx plus c or not? How can you find out roots of quadratic equation? You know very well. What is that? X is equals to minus b plus or minus root over b square minus, what is a b square minus 4a, 4ac by 2a. You know this is formula to find out the root of a quadratic equation. Minus b plus or minus root over b square minus 4ac by 2a. According to this one, minus b means what? X quotient is minus y, means plus y. Plus or minus root over b square. B square means minus y whole square is y square. Minus 4ab. 4 into 1 with the minus 1. 4 minus 1 is plus 4. By 2 into a. A is 1. Okay, 2. It becomes 2. Therefore, what I said? What I said to find out inverse? We can replace the in place of y is x. But we can understand here, in the given question, here you have to consider the given sets also, because of in the given question, this is a positive interval, this is also positive interval. There is no question of negative interval. That's why here no need to take the minus value, because of given intervals are positives, right? Now we can take x is only, what is that? X is only y plus root over y square plus 4 by 2. So for f inverse x, what you have to do? You have to replace in place of y is x. I am writing 1 by 2 is outside, 1 by 2 of in place of y taken as x, x plus root over x square plus 4. That's it. This is only our required f inverse x. Okay, what is that? Which option? It's clearly third option. You see, look at here in fourth option, third option, fourth option also actually according to this one, it must be correct. But you have to concentrate on this one, which is a correct option either, third or fourth, but depends upon this interval, it becomes a third option, because it is defined as only positive values, no negative values here. Okay, cut up what are the values are there, that one only can use. Okay. These are the various questions which are I discussed in this part 2 of the functions. Simply inverse, how can you find out? I am using the super tips and tricks. So, what are maybe your doubts? Put a comment. Please watch the video till end along with the part 1. So, already more and more videos are uploaded, guys. Please watch them. Whose playlists are added in the description. Those are very, very helpful to you. In MCET point of view, nothing to worry, just you have to do the practice more number of questions with the super tips and tricks. That is important here, because time is important. Within short time, you have to focus the more number of questions, that is possible when if you use a super tips and tricks. That is all I am using in my videos. I hope so. If you are following this video very well, if you make sure enjoy this video, please like, share and subscribe. I conclude this video is here. I will come with new topic with in new video. Till then, have a great time. Take care. Bye-bye.